I'm answering that question of how we came to have all these obstacles, serious obstacles, anger, lust, fear, which prevent us totally from waking up to the indivisible unity of life. This is our legacy. Through millions, billions of years of evolution, and in the Hindu scriptures, they use a very picturesque term, adyaropa. Whatever the misadventures that we have gone through in our animal stages, or even in our caveman stages, we superimpose them on ourselves. We attribute the characteristics of the body, because that's what the tiger identifies with, the crocodile identifies with, total identification with the body. But when we come into the human context, we have the choice. Shall I now identify myself totally with the urges of the body, with the demands of the body, or shall I begin to rise above the flux by putting love first, the welfare of those around me first, and giving to the world rather than grabbing from it first? In adyaropa, which is often translated as superimposition, we superimpose the characteristics of the container on the contained. I'll take one or two absurd examples. Take milk. What would you say if somebody told you the characteristics of the milk are the characteristics of the bottle? They say milk is made of glass. You can see through it. If you try to break it and drink it, it'll hurt your mouth. You'll find it very ridiculous. This is exactly what we do every day when we yield to the primordial urges of the physical body. And it is this superimposition that we have to break through in order to become aware of the unity of life, which is the divine ground of existence.